The ratio of the perimeters of two similar rectangles is 3:5. If the smaller rectangle has an area of 36 square feet, what is the area of the larger rectangle? Looking at our formal notes below, if the ratio of the sides of two similar polygons is a to b, then the ratio of the perimeters is also a to b. However, if the ratio of the sides of two similar polygons is a to b, then the ratio of the areas is a squared to b squared. So because we are given the ratio of the perimeters is 3:5, the ratio of the areas is 3 squared to 5 squared, which is equal to 9 to 25. But let's just say we don't remember these formal rules below. We should be able to use our problem-solving skills and still determine the ratio of the areas. Since all squares are rectangles, let's see if we can discover this property using these two squares here. Because we are given the ratio of 3:5, let's label the length of each side of this small square 3 units, and the length of the sides of the large square 5 units. We can easily see the ratio of the corresponding sides is 3:5, but let's verify the ratio of the perimeters is also 3:5, and then we'll find the ratio of the areas. The perimeter of the small square is equal to 4 times 3, or 12 units. The perimeter of the large square is equal to 4 times 5, or 20 units. The ratio of the perimeters, comparing the small square to the large square, is 12 to 20. The greatest common factor between 12 and 20 is 4. To simplify the ratio, we divide 12 and 20 by 4. 12 divided by 4 is 3, 20 divided by 4 is 5, giving us the ratio of 3:5 for the perimeters, which was given. And now let's find the ratio of the areas. The area of the small square is equal to 3 squared, or 9 square units. And the area of the large square is equal to 5 squared, which equals 25 square units, which means the ratio of the areas is 9 to 25, which does not simplify. And notice how if we start with the ratio of the perimeters, which is the same as the ratio of the corresponding sides, and then we square the 3 and we square the 5, we do get the ratio of 9 to 25, which does give us the ratio of the areas. Now that we know the ratio of the areas, we can determine the area of the large rectangle when the area of the small rectangle is 36 square feet. The ratio of 9 to 25, where 9 corresponds to the area of the small rectangle and 25 corresponds to the area of the large rectangle, we have the ratio of 9 to 25 must equal the ratio of 36 square feet to the unknown area of the large rectangle. So we'll use the variable A to represent the missing area. Because these two ratios must be equivalent, notice that 9 times 4 is equal to 36, which means to find the missing area, we multiply 25 by 4. 25 times 4 is equal to 100. The missing area is equal to 100 square feet. Let's write the answer as a complete sentence. The area of the larger rectangle is 100 square feet. I hope you found this helpful.